Hello everyone, I'm Dope on a Rope. Welcome to Project Zomboid. I'm going to start doing a little bit of talking on my videos. It helps get across the point of what I'm trying to do, easier than trying to type it all out. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Right, so I'm going to do a solo. Custom sandbox, as always. We'll do the top one, Mordra, I think it is. I don't know, the top one is easier. Right, what I've done, I've got a custom preset. So the zombie count will be normal, urban focused. The time, 2 hour days. So it gives you an hour of day, hour of night. Start month, I just put May the 4th, obvious reasons. 7 a.m. just cause. World, pretty much standard, except for the darkness during the night is now pitch black, so that would be interesting, to say the least. Everything else should be pretty much standard. Oh yeah, the time before the corpses disappear, I've put up, just because it feels a bit more authentic, I don't know. You know, they disappear normally within the month, and that's just a bit daft. This actually means you have to take into consideration the actual impact to your health and stuff from their bodies being around. The loot rarity and everything else is all standard until we get down to the advanced zombie options, where I've pissed about a bit and got population. This is all, so I don't know. Population multiplier I've put up a little bit. Start multiplier is the same. The peak I put up quite a lot. It's nearly at the top. So I'm guessing come the peak day, it's just going to be fucking chaos. But that'd be interesting. Hopefully by then I should have got my shit together and be ready. If not, then game over. Respawn, that's the thing. I've turned off all the respawns. So once you've killed the zombies, they won't come back. But you do still have a map's worth of zombies to get through. It gives you, in my opinion, something to aim for, because this is obviously a game where you make up your own rules. So, in a sense, you could say my aim for the game is to kill every zombie, maybe? That would be a dream, but yeah, very unlikely. But I just thought it's better than 2 days down the line, the zombies you've just killed have popped back up. You might still get the zombies come back to somewhere you've cleared, but at least they're not respawning, they are just migrating in from outside. So, I just feel that's quite good. As for my character, we've gone standard. Standard for me, which is brave, just because it just helps with the panic a little bit. It doesn't get rid of it completely, but it does help a bit. And inconspicuous, which means you're less likely to be spotted by the zombies. Sometimes I go for graceful, which means you make less noise while you're moving. But, I mean, ideally you'd have the three, but you can without having a negative, and I don't really want any other negatives. So I think that's better, because you can just be a bit further away. And then, I don't know, I just feel that's better. Character, I don't know, just try to make as close to me as you can get, except for that with glasses, but I don't want this poor bugger to have glasses. Yes, that's right. Right, let's see what happens. Oh god. The first bit's always the worst bit. Right, the plan is to get a car. You need to get a car, in my opinion, because you need somewhere to rest. You can just rest in a house, I get that. But if you have a car, you can rest while you're driving. Whereas in a house, you've got to sit there and hope nothing breaks in. But the aim at the moment would be get a car and then head to the gas station, I expect, because I'll need to get some fuel. On the way, I'll stop at the tavern, I think it is, and then grab some bourbon, because I'm going to need to make a Molotov cocktail. But we shall see how that goes. Right, let's just see what's going on. Alright, first things first. Alright, I normally like to start off and go to the TV. If you're quick enough, turn the volume down and put the life you're living on. It should boost up one of your skills. So that's always good. And hopefully it'll still give it to me when I'm searching. That is good. Drink some milk. Drink the soda to get the bottle. No weapons, that's the problem. I need a weapon. Oh, for fuck's sake. Give me a weapon. Oh, you can fuck off. Right, well, that's a piss take. Plunger. I don't think you can use a plunger. Can you use a plunger? You can't use a plunger. Okay. Old school. Oh. Is the answer. Right, let's have a look. Right. So, this is going to get chaotic. Always gets chaotic. Because you're not going to hide from all the zombies. You're normally going to end up with a trail of them behind you, regardless of what you try to do. So, in my opinion, you just need to find a car that's got a gas can in it while you're being chased. I mean, it's just inevitable. As long as you walk, they can't get you, so you're all right there. The problem is your stamina, so you'd want to ideally get a car with gas and a key before you end up highly... exhausted, so you can't actually sprint at all. This is a good miracle, but has it got a key? Okay, it's locked. So there could be a key in the house. We can come back to that. He might have fuel, but it's having a gas can or an empty bottle, which I don't at the moment. Fuck. Right, just keep looking. It's alright. Think of where there's a good place normally for cars. There is a church. I I think it's just over the back here. He's often got cars and not very many zombies. So that's sad. I can do it a gas can. Oh, you fucking... It's not a big deal. If I can't get a gas can, I can empty my bottle of water, but it's not the best option. It's been a while since I've played. Here we go. This is normally a good place for cars. Zombies to fuck off. Oh, good golly gosh. This would be perfect. Too good to be true. Oh, fucking run around the back, crouch down. Hopefully they'll lose track of where I was. Bloody hell. Okay, as long as I can get the bottle. Right, let me check for gas. Right, so he's got nothing. No gas, but we do have a car. Right, let's have a look around. For fuck's sake, just give me a car with some goddamn gas in it. Back to that van, see if he had gas. I do want to search the houses, but I need to get gas for the car. Then once I got the car, I can park up somewhere nice and quiet, and then sneak my way to the houses. Let's check this one. siphon gasoline. Good, good, good. Right. Can I wear pants? Wear the pants. Quickly wear the pants. I should take the long johns, really. Fuck it, wear them. Right, so that's good. Bottle of gasoline, that is just what I need, gets me somewhere safe, and from there I can gather more gasoline. Well, I say safe. Where I used to park for my other videos, because it's quiet now. Down the back here. Right, leave the car, leave the key in the car, in case you do die. Your other character has a car if you continue with the same map. Now when the goddamn garbage bellend. Right. Let's start exploring. I need to get a backpack. Food, to get some more water, definitely to get a Molotov cocktail and a lighter, then we'll go from there. Right. I apologise if I'm quiet, I'm not used to speaking on here, so hard to understand what level my voice needs to be at, but I'm hoping this is okay. I should take a crossword magazine in case. Drink the juice box, or you know, treat yourself. Grab a can opener. Put the jeans down. The VHS tapes which teach you stuff are always very handy to grab. I should store it somewhere. Probably put it in the car, obviously, till I need it. I should put all of this in the car, really. Well, it's quiet. I do need a bag. Take a can opener. Take the orange soda. Just take it all.
that's a cook. Go chuck my shit in the car. Those in case I come across more gasoline. Petrol, gasoline, Pardon me. Oh, I do apologize, it's not good. Off the street. Always on the lookout for how to use generators. That's such a rare bloody magazine to come across. You always want to grab it when you find it. Oh, you son of a bitch. Grab the books. I could grab it all. Turn the TV on, you never know when you might catch a channel that gives you a little boost in your stats. Someone's just shot a gun. I'll take that anyway. Take the books. Cooking pot's always handy. That's more late game, but better to be safe than sorry. So this is quite a good start, really. I've got a car, good condition car, I believe. I should check it. Got an axe, I've actually got a weapon. Got food and water. Need more fuel, but I can get that. Oh, I hear a fucking zombie. Check the house right at the end, and then double back, check some of the houses we've gone past. Bottle. I could take it anyway. You never know. It's a glass one, so it does come in handy for making molotovs. Juice box, drink it, why not? Turn the TV on. Life and Living. Ooh, I should take the alarm clock. Get rid of the other one, because it's got an alarm. In the morning. Oh, for fuck's sake. What sort of bags? Right. Drop this shit off and go check the other houses. Someone in the house. I saw him through the window. Quickly check the car. Has he got any gas? No, he's got no gas. So that's good. Crowbar. Oh yeah. I'll use that and save the axe. Axe is very handy, so don't want to waste it. Saw. I should take a saw, but I'll wait till I leave. Ooh, black digital, even better, perfect. Get rid of the alarm clock. Set the alarm. Went the wrong bloody way. Grab the jacket, extra protection. I will sweat, so I might have to take off the long johns because I don't need them on, really. The orange. Oh, taxi key. Take the fruit cocktail. Better kick in the nuts, so I'll take that. Right. Should put the key in the car. As a backup. Should have enough to get to the gas pumps if all else fails. There's a zombie. So, I'll take that because it's light. You can put a sword in a fanny pack, of course you can. Wear the leather jacket. Get rid of the ordinary jacket for the long johns. Nope, okay. Okie dokie, so things are going well. Got the ham, which I'll take when I leave. Stuff. Right, I'm going to go check out some more houses. If that doesn't work out for me in the sense of gasoline and a backpack, I'll probably just, I don't know, pray. I'll just skip ahead and move on to getting the gasoline from the petrol station and the bourbon from the pub. Tavern, please. In theory, anyway. We shall see what happens. Check the mailboxes, because you never know when they have magazines. That's not what you do. There is only a few zombies, I could probably kill them all. Nice. A house, I believe, when it looks like that. Now, I do believe a show starts every 6 hours, so it'd be at 6 o'clock, 12, 6 p.m., midnight, so on, so on. So, got a while till this next show. Oh, I want all of that, but I also want a goddamn backpack. Satchel, better than nothing. Good, good, good. Right, equip that on your back. Disinfectant, very handy. Eat the cheese, take the ice cream. Take the bottles. Oh, I want the goddamn cooking pot. I should take all of this. It's all helpful at some point. But it's living long enough to use it, is the problem. Grab it, fuck it, why not? Right, I think that's everything. Nothing in there. Okay. Checking the houses, see what comes up. Oh, fucking hell. Zombies, that's what comes up. Fuck's sake. Thank you. no point taking guns at the moment. Right, well, a satchel's better than nothing, so I can't really complain. So now I need to keep trying to find gasoline. Any books that will be of assistance would be handy too. Basically, you just want to get anything you can. Fill your car up while you're here. So we'll be coming back this way for a while. Get to the car and rest. Shit in the boot. No room in the boot. Okay, right. Where to now? Obviously I do need to get fuel, but I might pay to wait till tomorrow, because it will be a mission. Just get a bit of time, rest him up. Check some more houses, and I'll wait till morning, and then hopefully I'll be able to get some petrol and get some bourbon to make the Molotov cocktails. Ideally, I need a Molotov cocktail to clear the petrol station, and then a Molotov cocktail to clear the military base, which is where I'm planning to go once I've gathered enough goodies. Thank you. gasoline? Oh, yes. Ooh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Right, that's good. Extra gas. Should put some in there, but I won't. But I should. Shut your back so it's easier to equip. Boom, boom, boom. Eat some ice cream, fuck it. Still got time to check out some more houses. pasta. Very good. That's it. Fuck off. In case I'm still here at 6. Right, nothing else here. The time I should be able to make it back to my car before 6, so I get another extra boost in lesson, or lesson in somewhat. Training in some skill. Probably bloody cooking again, but better than nothing. Should start at 6, I believe. Till then, I shall start reading this. Ooh, outdoor life thing, that's carpentry. Survival might be fishing. Foraging? Ooh, fishing. Okie dokie. It's very handy. Especially if it gives you carpentry. Oh. Or if it gives you electrical. Or if it gave you electrical and mechanics. Oh, you could just jump straight into hot wiring cars. That'd be the dream. Thank you. Short but sweet. And if I'd have read the book, it'd have probably put me like pretty much at 2. the way. The sooner the better. In case I get an episode that teaches you mechanics. You don't even need to read it all, really. But to get the best bonus, you would. What's he got there? Tailoring. I never really do any tailoring. That's like, you'd be doing tailoring till you're like 10 years into the bloody game and your clothes are falling apart. And even then, you just kill a zombie, take his clothes. Tailoring's very, I don't know. You'd have to have a specific outfit you really liked. Like, there's a Santa Claus costume, I believe, so if you had that, then maybe you'd want to keep repairing it. Oh, bloody hell, it's coming up to 11 o'clock. Make sure you don't get lost. Door. Keep reading, because I'm pretty sure midnight you still get another episode of that TV show. I don't know, it's just like bloody shopping channel type shit. Right. Okie dokie. We're in that night there, I think. Right, everyone. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you could bloody hear me. We'll see how it goes. I'll listen to this back anyway and see how the voice level goes. But yeah, everything's going quite well so far. It's a good starting position. From here, get some bourbon and some rags to make Molotovs. Get a lighter. Try and top up the fuel tank at the petrol station or gas station that's nearby. But I might need a Molotov to clear the zombies first. If not, then I'll head straight over to the... I might go to the warehouse and try and grab some axes and bits and bobs like that. I don't know. We'll figure it out tomorrow. But anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy. And I will see you again next time. Take care, everyone.